As you know, the prosecution of this case started in April last year. This is now we are about 14 months of trial, of course, with some breaks. Dato Sri Najib, the accused in this case, is facing 7 charges. The first charge is under the Anti-Corruption Act for abuse of power, and then 3 charges for criminal breach of trust under the Penal Code, and 3 other charges under AMLA, anti-money laundering. And total, we have how many witnesses?
57.
The prosecution had called 57 witnesses, and after the judge called for the defense of the accused in all the charges, the defense called
19
witnesses, and thereafter, of course, this whole week the judge heard submissions. But what you heard in court is probably about 1/10 of actually the submissions made. The detailed submissions are contained in the about 2,000 over pages, both from the prosecution and defense, for the learned judge to consider, analyze, and evaluate the case. Of course, whenever a prosecution is commenced by the public prosecutor, it is the norm and criteria that it is only done after the prosecution itself has evaluated the evidence and finds credible evidence to cause the prosecution. And I think the prosecution has established its case on all the 7 charges. Now it is not for the prosecution to say we have proved all the necessary ingredients, and now it's up to the judge to evaluate our case, test it against the defense case, and see whether they have raised a defense, a reasonable doubt. And the burden on us is, of course, to prove our case beyond reasonable doubt. And I am convinced on the facts, on the prosecution side, that we have done our duty and we have proved our case beyond reasonable doubt. That's what the submission is all about. And now we being, in a sense, the prosecution will look at it from our perspective. Now the judge sitting up there has to look down in a totally unbiased manner to see whether we have proved our case and whether any doubt has been created. That's all I want to say. Is there anything else you'd like to ask?
This is your first case in the country involving a former serving prime minister.
Yeah.
How has it been handling this case?
See, everyone is equal before the law. So I think you would have seen in the conduct of the case proceeded just like all other cases. Where evidence was tendered and whatever needs to be said was said. Of course, it's always done courteously, and I think it is very important. Until when someone is charged, it's our case that is prima facie, we have a case. So I think we have, although he's accused being a former prime minister, I think he was given the respect as a former PM, but I don't think the prosecution spared in our duty to do what is right and what is necessary and proper. And he was cross-examined, you will recall, by us, by me in particular, for more than 10, 11 days. So I think it has been an experience in the sense it is quite daunting to be, even though I have about 42 years in practice, to cross-examine a former prime minister. But I think all in all, he, to be fair, many people will not like it, he was a witness who did not pull ranks. He answered those questions to the best of his abilities. Yeah.
Can you give us a sense of the timing? So July 23rd,
Yes.
Delivered the verdict, and if found guilty, and what kind of appeal process, and how long will it take before
okay.
finality?
All right. We have seven charges. As long as one's assuming, this is on assumption just for the time frame, if he's convicted of all or most or some of the charges, then the appeal, a notice of appeal has to be filed by whoever is the losing party who, if the defense accused is convicted, then they'll have to file the notice of appeal. If we lose the case, one or any, we'll have to file a notice. We have 14 days to file the notice of appeal. Then the judgment will come out. The judge has to give us a full written grounds of judgment. Then we will have to come up with a petition of appeal. So the decision of between the filing a notice of appeal and the petition of appeal, that period will be actually dictated by the judge, because how soon he can give the judgment. But looking at the 7 weeks the judge is taken, and knowing this judge is very, very diligent, as you can see in the course, he's quite fast and quick. I expect we will be getting a full grounds of judgment. So after that means from the 28th of July, we have 14 days, whoever, either side, the losing side, appeal 14. And thereafter, we'll have another 14 days to file the petition. And I expect, this is a guess, the court has to actually compile all the notes of evidence of witnesses. You know, whatever all the witnesses said, it has to be compiled. Of course, to assist the court, we have given what we have compiled. The defense has given theirs, and the court is preparing theirs to cross-check. That will have to be done. That will be the notes of proceedings or notes of evidence, and then the court has to compile all the 807 exhibits. Some are thin, some are thick. All that has to be put as volume, so it will be quite a huge volume of evidence. So once that is ready and sent to the Court of Appeal, then the Court of Appeal will call, usually once that is sent, the Court of Appeal will call for case management within about a month. And they will fix a date for hearing, and thereafter they will give us direction to file our written submissions for the Court of Appeal. If you ask me, roughly I would think from the date of decision, this appeal, knowing the president, I hope the MCO and all that is lifted a bit, because cases have slowed down a bit, will take approximately 4 to 6 months. And thereafter, whoever the losing party has another round of appeal, the same thing, and I expect another 4 to 6 months. So all in all, I expect longest about a year this case to be finally determined, earliest 8 months, if not a year. That's the estimate, I think. It all depends on the preparation of the record of appeal and the grounds of judgment. Firstly, these charges, criminal charges, whether you're a prime minister or your office boy, is the same sections. It is the same sentence. I think usually the post you hold will only come into play when it comes to sentencing. You know what I'm saying? Otherwise, it's the same. There's no difference. Yeah. I mean, a person who's an office boy and another person who's, say, holding the purse of the country, a finance minister, obviously the gravity of the offence will be seen differently by courts. Yeah.
More seriously for the person who's holding.
Of course, because you hold a more serious job and you ought to be more careful, you know? Yeah.
Will you be seeing through the entire appeal process then?
Yeah, I've been appointed for the whole process until the federal court. Yeah.
The defense tried to pull a technicality and
at the end.
At the end of
yeah,
the case.
Yeah.
But you have responded to
yeah,
that.
Yeah.
But
usually, I mean, the duplicity is a point, but by itself is not, as I said, is not, will not cause any, unless they have been prejudiced and misled in the conduct of the defense. But if you had conducted the whole defense and the whole submission, and just before you sit down, you say, I'm prejudiced, I think our view, we say it's afterthought and just a technical objection. Basically, we'll say you're trying your luck, okay? Okay, you have to do your best, so I can't blame them as lawyers. They always try their luck. Yeah, okay. This is actually more of a matter of opinion. Obviously, the conclusion of this case and the verdict will be the first case. This will be the first case against the Prime Minister of a country. Former Prime Minister of a country. So, obviously, and all the other cases are all related. 1MDB, actually, SRC is actually part. Yeah, it's a subsidiary of 1MDB, and all are related matters. Obviously, once this case comes to a conclusion, how the defense or even the prosecution want to evaluate the case is really up to them. You know, it's a prosecutorial decision. But as I say, whatever the verdict on the 28th of July is not a final verdict. Until the federal court finally gives judgment, it's anybody's guess, isn't it?
But certainly in your course, even though with the change of government, with now UMNO, you know, one of the ruling party, has it changed in any way how you conduct
it? No, honestly, you all would have seen in our conduct of the case throughout, even after the change, there's been no change in the stance of the prosecution. We have done it with the same interests and not in any way asked to back off. You know what I mean? That is, the case is run exactly as we started. The political change has never impacted on the prosecution. And I'm very grateful for that, because law and order should not depend on the political parties that are running the country. It should depend on the law and the justice. Yeah.